Hello beautiful people of the internet, and thank you for tuning into this video. Today I'm going to show you my Aaliyah CD collection. If you clicked on this video out of curiosity and you don't know who Aaliyah is, Aaliyah was a R&B singer in the 90s, 2000s. In 2001, she passed away in a plane crash. That was a very tragic moment for a lot of people all around the globe who followed her work. And yeah, maybe I'll do a separate video about that, about her life and who she was and how she influenced the whole music industry with her presence. If you're interested in that, let me know in the comments below. If you haven't seen my whole CD collection, there is a link right there. Check it out. It's a good video. So yeah. So before we start, I have separated my Aaliyah CDs into two piles. I have one pile which is just the albums that I have, and the other pile are the singles that I have. Both piles I have chronologically ordered, sorted out chronologically. Yeah. If I have a couple of CDs that are misplaced, please forgive me. Let's start. So I really want to go in depth and show you how the CD looks from the inside and what special songs for me are on these albums. So the first one is H Ain't Nothing But a Number, which was released in 1994. This was her first album. And let's have a look inside. That's so cool. One of my favorite tracks is definitely Back and Forth. Wanna see you, wanna see you go. As you can tell, it was produced by R. Kelly because his name is very big on the back of the CD. And yeah, that was her first album. So let's continue with the second one. Her second album was One in a Million, which was released in 1996. Like, that's the CD, that's the inside of the album. The lyrics. Yeah, the lyrics, some pictures of her. That's her second album that I just destroyed. So what I really liked about this album was the song Your Love Is One in a Million. Goes on and on and on. You give me a really good feeling all day long. Third album from Aaliyah was called Aaliyah, and it's completely in red. There are different versions. I think I've seen a purple one. I think I bought this also at a flea market for €2. Look at that, it's beautiful. Let's have a look at the pamphlet. We have some artwork right there. Look at those pictures, man. She's so beautiful. She is so beautiful. Wow. This is definitely one of my favorite albums of Aaliyah. And I really, really wanted to have that one. It was released, by the way, in 2001. One of my all-time favorites is I Care For You. That was her third album. Beautiful, beautiful. Executive producers Aaliyah Barry Hankerson, which is her uncle, and Jomo Hankerson. I don't know, but probably a relative as well. Her fourth album, posthumous album, is Aaliyah I Care For You. Let's check the inside. It's kind of broken, but yeah, it's still, I can still put it together. And anyways, the CD is beautiful. We have a beautiful CD right here. Let's have a look at the pamphlet. There are no lyrics. It is just pictures, beautiful pictures of Aaliyah, some credits. Yeah, these are the albums that I have. Let's continue with the singles. So we have Hot Like Fire, the one I gave my heart to. Released in, let me check, so 1996-1997. Then Aaliyah, Journey to the Past, definitely one of my top 5 movies. I did not know until recently that Aaliyah sang the song Journey to the Past, which is one of my favorite tracks in this movie. I got this, I think, last year, also online. That's how it looks inside. 1997 released, and we have Journey to the Past, the Aaliyah version, performed by Aaliyah, and also performed by Liz Calloway, which is the official version in the music video. The next single is Are You That Somebody, that appeared in a Dr. Dolittle movie, if you remember this movie, released in 1998. Are You That Somebody. Next single is Aaliyah's Romeo Must Die, or from the movie Romeo Must Die, which Aaliyah also starred in, is Try Again. Also one of my favorite songs from Aaliyah. And then we have some remix versions on that as well. This is how the CD looks like from the inside. Very nice, very beautiful. Next single that I have is We Need a Resolution, featuring Timbaland. Timbaland is a master, straight up master producer. What songs and what things what samples he used for his music is just mind-blowing to me. I have so much respect for Timbaland and his work. Fun fact, he even admitted in one interview that he was in love with Aaliyah and he really loved her, but he wanted her to have her freedom and decide for herself where to go personally and musically. It was just the perfect pair, the perfect couple, together with Missy Elliott, perfect group to work together on these musical pieces. It's just amazing. So we have We Need a Resolution, featuring Timbaland album version, Be Messed Up, Are You Feeling Me, and We Need a Resolution. Love, love, love that song. The next single that we have is Aaliyah's I Refuse and More Than a Woman. I can't explain to you how much I Refuse means to me. There's like this horse galloping. It's a story. The song is a story. It's not a song. It is a story that has so much power, and I'm just completely speechless. But I have this single right there. More Than a Woman. Beautiful. Next one is Aaliyah Rock the Boat. The last music video that she ever made was Rock the Boat. When I read about her death, specifically how she died, she didn't actually die from the plane crash. She died because of a heart attack, probably caused by the fear during the plane crashing. So it was not actually the plane crashing, it was because she was so scared she got a heart attack during that flight. Must have been terrible. I mean, she died, of course it was terrible, but imagine you're in a plane and you know you're going to die and you just die out of heart attack because you're so scared. It's crazy. So Rock the Boat is also in my collection. There are different club mixes on here. That's how the inside looks. The second last single that I have, which was released after her death, of course, 2003, is Aaliyah's I Miss You. I miss you. And the last single that I own is Aaliyah's Don't Know What to Tell You. I'm kind of mixed it up because this was released, as I just said, in 2003. Yeah, 2003 and 2002. So this is the last CD that I have from Aaliyah. What else can I say? Well, of course, there are a couple of CDs that are still missing, but I'm really glad that I have the basis. Almost forgot. I just read today that they actually settled, like all of the record companies who had collaborations with Aaliyah and her uncle actually settled to release her music on streaming platforms, which is great. I would love to see that. I'm really looking forward to it. But I will definitely still collect her music on CD, on vinyl, as much as I can get. These are all of my Aaliyah CDs. I would definitely love to make a separate video about Aaliyah, who she was, what she did exactly. If you're interested in that, please leave a comment. Let me know what you think. And please consider subscribing. Also, I am thinking about doing a Patreon in which you can, well, support me if you would like to. So if you would like to support me, let me know. I would love to make one. So yeah, if you have any suggestions what else I could make a video about, please let me know. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Bye bye. It's been a long time, long time. We shouldn't have left you without a dope beat. Step two. It's been a long time. We shouldn't have left you without a dope beat. Step two. Step two.